अस्सलाम
यस, वालेकुम अस्सलाम। हाउ आर यू ऑल?
वी आर ग्रेट अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह। व्हाट अबाउट यू सर?
अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, आई एम गुड आल्सो। यस, सो आई थिंक टुडेज पेपर इज वेरी फैंटास्टिक फॉर एवरीवन। इट विल बी
वेरी फैंटास्टिक। इट वाज रियली ऑसम।
एवरीवन नाउ टचिंग द स्काई, आई थिंक। सो it is quite easy, alhamdulillah, and as you prepared, that's why it is easy. Okay, so what we have to do today, beta?
So should I tell?
Yes,
today we will be starting new chapter, which is chapter number 4, atomic structure.
Okay, that is good. So yes, everyone listen to me carefully. Okay. Yes, tell me one thing, but only that my screen is visible or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now, alhamdulillah, we are going to start. We have completed, alhamdulillah, 3 chapters, and now we are starting chapter number 4. Okay.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Chapter 4, that is atomic structure. Okay, this is the chapter. And before starting, everyone knows about this, that in this chapter, what we have to do, we have to learn about means delta and atomic theory, about discharge, discoveries of subparticles, okay, and about electronic configuration is also in this chapter. So this chapter is very, very interesting. Okay, very interesting, because everything upcoming chapters are based on it, and this is one of the important chapter for the upcoming classes. So everyone knows about matter. Okay, what is matter? That everything with that contains mass and occupies space. Mass and occupies space, this is called matter. That is called matter. So it is here that many philosophers have proposed their opinions about matter. Okay, so we also know that in India, there was a philosopher. Okay, Indian philosopher is there, whose name was Maharishi Kannad. Okay, so Indian philosopher is there, whose name is Maharishi Kannad. Okay, so listen to me carefully, because in the end, as I am doing, I am going to ask the questions, boys and girls. Okay, so around 600 BC, it is there. It was there, and what he says, what he studied, what he observed, that particles are indestructible. Okay, he says that particles consist of indestructible particle called Pramanu. Indestructible particles, and what the name he is given? He is given the name as Parmanu. Okay, and in modern, we can say that is atom. It is atom basically. Okay. So he says that it is indivisible, we cannot divide it further, and it is never available in free state. Okay, it's never available in free state. Or he also says that when two or more Pramanus combine, they form and bigger. That is called Devanuka and Trinuka. These are some Sanskrit words. Okay, in English it is called dimolecules and triatomic molecules. Diatomic molecules stands for Dianuka. Okay, something that's difficult to pronounce. And then another one is Trinuka. Okay, whatever. So this is the stands for diatomic molecules and triatomic molecules. And he observes certain properties that these atoms have, this Pramanu has some specific properties. Okay, so Pramanu has specific properties. Okay, what he observed, specific properties. Second is that not found in free state. Okay, combined to form bigger Pramanu. That is called Anu. Okay. So, this is some observations which is with our Indian great philosopher Maharishi Kannada observed that after that. This Maharishi Kannada, another one comes whose name was Democritus. Okay, Democritus is a Greek philosopher and he used the word atomos. Okay, and that is indivisible. Who comes after this? After this, who comes?
Democritus. And so there was one more scientist at that time who also contributed, and he was Leucippus.
Yes. Maharishi. Okay. After that, we come another that is Democritus. Okay. Then he gave, he observed the things also and he gives a name called Atomos, which means that indivisible. Okay. And he what he observed, what the observations? He observed that atoms are always in motion. Okay, means atoms are always motion. Another thing what he observed is that it is indestructible. Okay, means we cannot break it. So these are the two main observations. Okay. After that, Dalton's come with a theory. Okay, and he gives some postulates. Okay, till now we one of the Indian scholars there, philosopher is there. Second is some one Greek philosopher or is there, and now comes Dalton's. Okay, so he gave some. Full name was basically John Dalton. He gives some postulates. Okay, some postulates are given by John Dalton. And what he says, what are these postulates? These postulates basically says that, first postulate says that it is made up of, means of matter is made up of very minute particles, okay, called atoms, very minute particles called atom. Another thing is that atoms are neutral. Okay, these are the points, these are the some postulates by Dalton. Another one is that he says atoms of an element are identical in mass and properties. Means atom of certain thing, particular element, this means that particular element consists of that only particular atoms. Okay. and these are take part in chemical reactions. Okay, these atoms takes part in chemical reactions also. And after that, another postulate says that they combine to form compound and molecules, and they should be in fixed proportions. So these are some postulates given by John Dalton, and they are fixed proportions, means fixed quantity is there. Is it clear? So these are certain postulates given by Dalton. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, it is.
Can anyone except Nabiha conclude this, all the postulates?
Sir, should I, Munazza?
Only 16 participants are there. What happened? You got tired after giving the test?
No, yes, sir, the test is very easy.
Only, but number of participants are by less. Okay, tell me.
Sir, me?
Yes, me, Munazza, you tell me.
Okay, sir. So, sir, we can conclude from Dalton's atomic theory that, sir, should I state what he told?
Yes.
Okay. So, sir, as we all know, it's very common. We have been studying this thing since atoms came in our studying syllabus, that atoms are, according to the Dalton's theory, that atoms are indivisible and they cannot be created nor destroyed. But after furthermore researches, we got to know that atoms are divisible.
It means that this theory is neglected. Some drawbacks are there in this theory.
Yes, sir. Some drawbacks are there of Dalton's atomic theory as well.
Yes, because we know that there are some other particles, subparticles which are present in atoms.
Subatomic
particles. Yes, very good, mashallah. Yes, go ahead.
Yes, so for 90 years, they were considering this theory correct. But after 90 years, it was discovered that the theory was entirely wrong.
It was wrong. Finally, we got the information that it is wrong. Okay.
Yes, exactly.
Yes,
Vidal. And sir, the next point is that all the matter is made up of very minute, and they can be electrically charged or neutral.
Okay.
And the atom of one element, they're different. The atom of gold is different from the atom of silver.
Exactly.
And sir, if there are two elements and they combine to form a compound, then compounds, one atom will contain both the elements of the first of its element and the second element, which made the compound.
Okay.
And the atoms of an element
means that they should be in fixed quantity. The constituent elements, sir, which are taking part in making something new, molecule or compound or mixture, so there should be some fixed.
Yes, sir.
No.
For example,
I am telling compound and mixture. In the mixture, fixed proportions are not there.
No, sir, not mixture, only compounds.
Okay,
and yes, sir, when atoms combine, they combine in numerical ratios. For example, for water, it is H2O. And the number of hydrogen in H2O, it's 2, and the number of oxygen atom is 1. So it's 2:1.
Okay, that's good. Yes, that's nice.
And
just if any point left, yes, continue fast, beta, because I have to.
And so the atoms are the smallest unit of the matter that can take place in a chemical reaction, although they may have independent existence or they may not have independent existence. Yes, sir. All the points are covered.
Okay. So in short, we can say that
sir, all the points were correct of Dalton's atomic theory, except the one which stated that atoms are indivisible.
Yes, very minute particles. First thing, okay, indivisible. Okay, another thing, neither created nor destroyed.
So it is law of conservation of mass.
Yes.
There were matter two operations which were held after 90 years.
Ratios are fixed. Yes, ratios are fixed. Okay, atoms take part in chemical reactions. Yes. Is it clear, all of you? Yes, why? Voice are sleeping?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, please.
Okay, only one voice get up. Others are still sleeping. MashaAllah. Got so
yes,
much
sir, I've understood.
Okay, I will ask the question. Be there at the end, okay? Yes, so this is all about Daltons, John Dalton. And here now we come to some cathode ray experiment. Okay. Cathode ray experiment. Yes. Yes, boys. Anyone go through it about cathode ray experiment? Yes, Nabiya, do you wait for a second? Okay.
Sir,
yes.
Should I?
You both. Zain, Nabiya. Yes,
yes sir?
From the boy side. I'm asking, wait for a second. Let me give this question to boys. Okay. Yes. Means only two girls are studying since 2 months, 3 months. What happened to boys? Where is Sheikh Vidyan? Where is other students? Yes, beta. Tell me, this is very, very interesting. Means a lot of information is there, how electrons coming and how they are bombarding. Okay, how the image is formed when something is coming on the path of some rays. Okay, so these are very interesting. These things are very good because these things you can know, you can see it. Okay, there are a lot of experiments are there. Okay. So you can know the charge about charge experiments, how they come into existence, what are CRT. CRT are there in television also earlier, and computers are also cathode rays tube are there. Okay, so this is very interesting chapter, beta. Everyone's participate in this chapter. How this comes, you, if you don't know how this comes, then how will you continue in the upcoming chapters? You should know about some knowledge of these things. Yes, students from the boys side, who is yes, Ammar Zaid, please tell me about this. Ammar Zahid.
Yes, sir.
Yes, beta. Tell me about this cathode ray experiment. Anyone from the boys can tell me. Yes, from the girl side. Tell me, Nabiya, who performed cathode experiment.
Sir, please again tell your question.
Okay, yes, Mohammed Umar. Wait, Nabiya. Please tell me about this discharge cathode ray experiment. Okay. I'm telling you, listen to me, and I'm going to ask a question. Okay. William Crookes. Okay. Perform this experiment. Okay. Who performed it first? William Crookes performed ray cathode ray experiment. And
Sir, J.D. Thomas.
Yes, beta.
Sir, J.D. Thomas performed the experiment.
Beta? J.J.
Thomas.
Yes. I'm getting to this how it comes to J.J. Thompson. Okay. This is cathode. Okay, that is electron. Beta, this is clear, Nabiya?
Yeah. Yes.
This is, I'm talking about cathode. Then how it comes to electron discovery, that took place by J.J. Thomson in 1897. Is it clear, beta? Okay. So, first of all, what he do? He took a glass tube, okay? And he put some electrode in one side and one electrode in this side, and this is the what we say, it is your negative terminal. Okay, so it is your negative terminal, what is called as It is called as cathode.
Sir, the negative terminal is called as cathode and the positive as anode.
This is your positive terminal. Okay. So it is called as anode. What happened then? He connect a battery, take a battery. And yes, negative will go to positive or it will go to negative?
Sir, negative.
Yes, tell me.
So negative charges attract each other, whereas positive.
No, positive charges.
No. I am asking.
The same charges are repelling, and the different are attracting.
Okay. So should I? Where I have to connect this thing?
Sir, positive will be attracted to positive. I mean, it will be attached.
Attract
to
the or repelled?
No, simple. No, sir, I'm not saying attract or repel.
Listen, it's very simple. Negative terminal always go to negative part. Okay, see in your battery, inverter battery, and positive terminal will go to positive. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Then what happened? We put vacuum and put out all airs. Okay, and there is certain pressure we built in that. Okay. The pressure is very, very low. Okay. So after that, what he observed that some of the beams, some particles are coming and going in this direction. Why it is going in this direction? Some of the particles are moving from negative to positive. Okay. Because yes. Why? Because we studied in physics that opposite charges attract. Okay. And like charges repel. Don't get confused that we are connecting the wire, okay, from negative to negative and plus here plus positive to positive. Okay. This is physics law that opposite charges attract and like charges repel. Okay. And what is the condition for this experiment to be performed? Okay. There should be a vacuum. Okay. Pressure should be very low. This is the condition for this. High voltage is there. Pressure is very low. And it is around 10,000, or we can say it is a range of 10 to 20 kV, basically. Okay, 10,000 volt to 20,000 volt, and pressure should be very, very low. Okay, so what we do when this condition is provided in this discharge tube? Okay, so what happened?
Pressure is for about 0.001
mmHg. Yes, of Hg. Okay, what happened that? When we do create such type of environment in this tube, we see that particles travel in a straight line. Okay, some of the particles which travels in a straight line. And remember this thing, this path is fixed. Okay, they will not go because discharge takes place from this side. Okay, so it will go in this direction. As it is a law of negative, will go to positive, so it will go in this way. And another thing is that regarding this is that if we put something, okay, if we put something here, anything, so a shadow is cast. Okay, if we put something as beams are coming out of this negative part, cathode part. Okay, that's why it is called cathode rays. Rays are coming from cathode. That is why it is called cathode rays experiment. Is it clear? And a shadow is cast on the other side, opposite of cathode. This should be very much clear. Okay, and here also it is seen that light paddle wheel, okay, as there are particles there, okay, so when we put this is your cathode, this is your anode. If we put some, means a wheel So it will start paddling, rotating. Okay, when we hit by these cathode rays. Okay, so this is the basic fundamental of this experiment. Okay, and after that, there is another thing. When what we observed here, these particles travels in a straight line. Okay, there will be no deflection. There is no any deflection there. Okay, they will go straight. No deflection is there. So it means that what we concluded.
So and one more thing, I yes, studied madam. That like in the anode part, when the rays were coming from the cathode
anode
side.
Anode part or cathode part? You just said anode part.
When the cathode rays were coming and hitting the anode, which was there on the positive side, so I studied that behind the you know, the bar which is there, which is the slit iron bar is there for anode. Behind that, there was a layer of zinc sulfide, which was whenever any current used to hit that, so it would turn yellow or greenish in color.
Yes. That's right. I'm coming to that. Means you see in the figure also. Okay, greenish yellow glow is there. Okay, yes, everyone is seeing a yellowish or greenish yellow is there on the anode side when it hits the rays on the anode. That's very good, mashallah. Okay, so yes, this thing is clear to you, everyone. Yes,
yes, sir.
Boys, this please conclude this to me fast. Okay, let me know how you from the starting, from the name of that philosopher, Indian philosopher, till here, fast.
So please, can I really came prepared for all this.
I know, beta, because I know this thing that you will definitely answer me. Okay. And as I told this also, beta, that everyone get chance and everyone is, I am here for everyone. I want everyone will participate in my discussion, my class. Okay. So this is your responsibility also, beta, that in your class, have your friends also get the chances. Okay. Yes, beta. Boys, please, boys, hurry up. Anyone? Yes. Sheikh Fidyan, you are there also, mashallah. You should tell me. Yes, someone is flipping the pages. Okay. Yes, Zainul Abdin. Lots of there, beta. Means your preparation is just shown in the class, how much you are preparing, how much you are taking the part in the discussion. Okay.
Sir, should I explain?
Manaza, you wait for a while again. Yes, boys, hurry up, beta. I don't have full day for you. I have to complete another thing also. Yes, anyone is ready to tell me except these two girls? Yes, anyone other girl? Azra Shafi, Dua Khan. Yes. Sadiqa. Sumaiya Aziz.
Sir, what's your question?
Beta, what you are listening in the class? If you listen me carefully, then you know what I'm asking.
Sir, actually, I got disconnected, so I wasn't able to listen what you said.
This is the one of the most beautiful excuse, you know. You are disconnected from the beginning. How much time you get disconnected? Okay, tell me whatever you listened in this class. Yes, Munazza, fast, tell me. I don't know what happened. Only two girls are studying since the beginning.
Yes, sir. Sir, actually, I'm getting disconnected frequently, so I may get disconnected again. I'm facing connection problems.
Okay.
So in the discharge tube experiment, we have a long glass which is closed from both the ends, and it has two metal plates attached to it. The first is plate A and the second is plate B. And plate A acts as a negative terminal, and we know the negative terminal is always called cathode and the positive terminal is called anode. And plate B is attached to the positive terminal anode. And then, sir, we have to create a vacuum inside the glass tube through a vacuum pump. And we'll have to attach the cathode and anode with a high voltage source. And then we have to pass a high voltage of about 10,000 volts across the plates, both the plates, plate A and plate B. And obviously, there is a very less pressure due to the vacuum.
Okay. Yes, what happened, beta?
So she left the meeting. I think she got disconnected.
Again, okay. So yes, these things are very important. And again, I'm telling you this thing, Nabiya, listen it carefully. Why it is called discharge tube? Because it is called discharge that suppose discharge means conduction is there. Okay, what we are doing, we are connecting the wires with the battery. Okay.
Sorry, sir. I disconnected.
Okay, I am saying that it is called, why, what is discharge? Basically, discharge means some conduction is there. Okay. Electrical conductions is there. Okay. There is some gas, there is some, a little bit, as we do vacuum. So a little bit of gas is there, okay. So that conduction takes place, okay. So that is why it is called discharge. As it is takes place in a tube, glass tube, that is the complete name, is got a discharge tube. Yes, is it clear, beta?
Yes,
Alhamdulillah.
Sometimes, beta, listen, sometimes hydrogen gas is also used, okay, in it. Little amount of hydrogen gas is also used. Okay.
So the discharge tube experiment?
Yes.
Okay, sir, but they didn't mention it, right?
But actually, I am telling this thing, this is not given you a course. It is something beyond this.
It's okay. A fire?
Okay.
Classes.
Okay.
Should I continue with from where I left?
Sir, I have a question. Can I ask?
Yes, beta, please.
Okay, so like in the discharge tube,
what is
the
this? Who is this? Mohammed Umar? Yes, beta.
Yes, sir. In the discharge tube, the rays are coming, the cathode rays are coming from the cathode side, the negative side, and they're going towards the anode side because the opposite charge attracts. So basically, as we already know, that the pressure was in their experiment, pressure was for about 0.001 mmHg.
Yes.
So, sir, pressure was there. And the particles, we know that the particles which were there, in the cathode plate A, they were going towards the plate B, which is the anode.
Okay.
So pressure was also there. Now, pressure is what? It was, although the air was very less present there, the pressure was very less, but air was present there. And air is also having particles. So and obviously the particles might be having negative and positive charges. So where were those charges?
No, we have used the vacuum pump to take out all the air.
Listen to me. Okay. What's your question basically? What you want to ask? Just tell me, okay. What do you want to ask basically?
Okay. Like we know that the particles, the cathode rays were coming from the cathode side and going to plate
you are,
B. Which
you are asking about the low pressure. Why it is there?
No, sir. Okay. Please.
No, Munazza, please just give me a second.
Wait.
The pressure.
Yes,
the pressure which was being formed, that pressure is also air because we just minimized the air present there. We took out all the air, but the air was still present there. It was present in a very low amount, but it was still present there.
Beta, listen to me. Okay. Yes, good question, mashallah. So listen to, for electric discharge, okay, for the discharge to be takes place, or in other words, we can say that for electrical conduction, okay, so through gases, so pressure inside this glass should be lower. This is a condition for electrical conduction in gases. The pressure should be low and what is high? The voltage should be very high. Around, it is hit here, 10,000 means It is basically, it's a range, not fixed 10,000. How it is fixed? It is around 10 to 20 kV kilo watts. Okay. For performing this, this is the conditions. Is it clear, Nabiya beta? But not, yes, I'm audible.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. Yes, is it clear?
Yes, sir, you are
so, clear. So another thing, yes, this is clear, na? This condition is required for performing this thing.
I'm sorry, if I did not hear you because there is so much noise.
Listen to me. Okay, I'm saying that for a conduction of electric charge, okay, to be takes place, this condition we have to provide. Low pressure and high voltage. Okay. There is a range also for voltage. It is written 10,000 volt. So there is a range also 10 to 20 kV, I think. Okay. So this thing is required for performing, or this conditions is required so that this experiment should take place. As it is, you know, gold foil experiment is there. So gold foil is necessary. Okay. Is it clear?
I think so. You are getting my question. See, I'll let you know. Discharge tube is there.
Listen, you text me. Okay, I am completing this thing because it is running out of time.
I'll let you know on WhatsApp.
You WhatsApp me. I am saying you WhatsApp me.
Okay. Okay, that's okay.
So electron is some atomic particle. Another thing is that proton, and the last one is that neutron. So here, how we get the discovery of electron? Okay, so who discovered electron? J.J. Thomson. Okay, who J.J. Thomson was there? Who discovered the electron? And he's taking the same cathode rays. Okay. He is taking the same cathode rays, and what he observed in that. Okay. Suppose that when discharge takes place, okay, when discharge takes place from cathode to anode, okay, this switch takes place in a straight line earlier, okay. And it is takes at going to anode. Okay, what he observed that when he put charged rod, okay, near it, when he put charged rod near it, or charged plates, or when he put plates here, some charged plates here, what he observed, he got deflection is there. Okay, some rays get deflected. Deflection takes place. Okay, deflection takes place. So that particle which get deflected on putting the plates or putting the charge rod, so he gave the name of this particle as electron. Okay, is it clear to everyone? Yes.
Yes, sir.
So this is the basic of thing that you should know about discharge tube, how cathode rays. These are the pet questions of every exam and test. Okay. About cathode rays, about this experiment, discovery of electron. We should know the figures also. Yes, is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir, it is clear.
Okay, I'm not giving you homework, okay, but if you get time, so please try to make its notes, okay, because if we go it, and then there will be no burden on you, okay.
I've already made notes of this topic.
Sir, I've already studied the chapter.
Yes, you studied earlier also, okay, mashallah, that's very nice. Yes, so this thing is clear to you, okay, about this discovery of electrons takes place. And he also observed that there is a constant charge of cathode, and it is also tell that it is 1 upon 1840 times mass.